For latest updates, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon.
Hello and welcome to this part 5th of my video series on aviation terminology. This is in continuation of part 4, where you have learned about the air cargo, various air cargo, main common terminology which is used in handling of air cargo. In this, you are going to learn about the different type of cargo related terms which are used in day-to-day cargo handling business. So let us start with the part 5, integrator. Carrier, integrating different modes of transport to form a door-to-door transport or supply chain. This term mostly refers to the large international express companies whose core business is to carry envelopes, parcels up to the 75 kg, often overnight or even same day. Notify party. Party other than the consignee to be notified on arrival of goods at destination. NOTOC. This is the notification to captain, informing captain the type of different type of cargo that is loaded into aircraft or the position that is the cargo is loaded in. Minimum rate. Rate to cover the basic cost of carrying shipment by the airline. End rate basically is the normal rate, which is weighing the shipment less than 45 kg. Volume charge. This is the charge air transport based on the volume of goods instead of actual weight. Weight charge. Air transport charge based on the actual weight of the goods. Over pivot rate. Rate per kg to be charged for the over pivot weight. Over pivot weight. Weight in excess of the pivot weight. OAG. This is official airline guide for its comprehensive information and service to the world's airlines, airports, global distribution system specifically for air cargo solution. Operating carrier. Carrier whose flight number is being used for air traffic control purpose. All operational and traffic items should be reported by the operating carrier to the authorities. Direct operating cost, also known as DOC. This cost incurred in operating the aircraft, which covers the cost of flight operation, flight equipment maintenance and overhaul, flight equipment depreciation and user charges, etc. Indirect operating cost, IOC. This is the remaining operating cost apart from the direct operating cost, such as station expenses, passenger service cost, ticketing, sales and promotion and general or the administrative expenses. Overbooking. The practice of allowing more capacity to be booked than the carrying capacity of the flight because it is expected that a part of the booking will be cancelled or will not show up for the departure. Overcarried cargo. Cargo that accidentally ended up at the wrong destination, maybe due to the wrong build up of the cargo on the pallet or wrong labeling or marking. Any reason could be for the cargo which is reaching to the wrong destination. Overbooking. The situation when more cargo is sold before departure than the aircraft, the flight is known as overbooked. Oversized cargo. Cargo that exceeds the dimension of the ULD is known as oversized cargo. Overhang cargo. Cargo packages which is loaded into PMC by overlapping into other PMC due to the size of packages or its size. Packing list. A list for custom declaration and consignment purposes, stating the number and the kind of packages being shipped, total of gross and net weight of the packages, marks and numbers on the packages, contents and part and serial number, etc. Payload. Payload is the cargo load that can be carried by an aircraft to to generate the revenue for the airline. Payload capacity. Total payload capacity available in metric tons above and below the deck for the carriage of revenue load, passenger baggage, freight and mail, etc., taking into account any payload and operational restriction on the supply of the capacity of an airline. POD is basically the proof of delivery and is the legal proof of a shipment that has been delivered to the right party or the consignee. Prefix. It is an airline identification number stated before the serial number of an airway bill or a ticket number. For example, EK is Emirates Airlines and the numeric code is 176. RCF. That means cargo has arrived in cargo warehouse or at final destination, or the cargo airway bill are administratively received in the system. RCS means cargo and documents are received or ready for carriage and accepted by the airline. Ready for carriage. The goods are correctly packed, labeled and custom cleared with the right documents attached to the cargo shipment is known as ready for carriage for the airline. Sea air move. When the goods move partly by sea or partly by air, known as the transport as sea air mode, this is basically used to curtail the cost of the freight. Security surcharge. Surcharge added to the cargo rate to cover the additional cost of the increasing number of security checks and related administration that are legally required by the authorities. Shipper. Shipper is a person or an organization that is physically and administratively responsible for shipping the goods. An airline, in most cases, a forwarder will be the shipper. For a forwarder, the shipper is the third party, for example, a trading company or a manufacturing unit, etc. Shipper's letter of instructions. The document issued by the shipper to instruct and authorize the forwarder to forward and declare goods on his behalf contains all shipment details needed to facilitate the services provided by the freight forwarder. Incoterms, also known as international commercial terms. The International Chambers of Commerce developed Incoterms in 1936 and updates them periodically to conform to changing the trade practices and updating the trade about the new terms and condition of the international business. Short shipped cargo. This is basically cargo that was not fully loaded on board of an aircraft, but which is nevertheless listed in the manifest. In the short shipment is also known after the aircraft departed, then the airway bill will have to be split and the manifest will be amended accordingly. Skid, or a pallet made from wood or plastic, which is used to move cargo within the warehouse or onto truck from the warehouse to the truck or a vice versa. Split shipment, a shipment that is split over different ULDs traveling on the same flight or the same day is known as split shipments. Spoilage, this is the loss of revenue due to unused aircraft cargo capacity is known as spoilage. TECT, the air cargo tariff, publication of official airline tariff by the IATA. Technical stop, a stop most commonly used to refuel the aircraft or to make unexpected essential repairs or to respond to some kind of emergency. Thank you for watching this video, and if you find this video helpful, please share it with your colleagues and friends so that they are also benefited from this knowledge. And once again, if you have not subscribed the channel, please do so that you can get notification as and when we upload the new video.
For detailed learning of all logistics subjects, visit www.logivada.com.